Welcome to our Azure Data Studio tutorial for beginners. In this tutorial, we will connect to an SQL server. We will write SQL queries and notebooks. We will install and run Python from Azure Data Studio. We will export data to various file formats including CSV and Excel files. We will visualize data using charts and customized dashboards and Sanddance visualization extension. So, stay with us, and we hope you enjoy the tutorial. Azure Data Studio looks like this. On the welcome page, you see four large buttons. Here you can connect to a database or server. Run an SQL query. Create a notebook. Or deploy a server. You will find the same options in the new button as well. Here you can open files and folders. On the left side, you have the connections button, which opens the connections pane. Here you will find all currently connected servers and databases, listed in hierarchical form. Then you have the Find and Replace pane, which you can use to find and replace stuff in files. You can use the Notebook pane to create Jupyter notebooks and write Python, R, and Scala codes. You can create and open database projects. You can explore files and folders. You can collaborate with others and track changes to your code using source control. And you can install and use extensions in Azure Data Studio. Finally, you can use the Settings button to change various settings in Azure Data Studio. You can also hide these panes and create more screen space. Let's start by creating a connection. We have a local SQL server, and if we want to connect to that server, we will enter its name in the server field. Since it is a local server, we can simply use the Windows authentication and click on the Connect button. Click on the Enable Trust Certificate as well. And now we are connected to our local SQL server. Here we can see all the databases in the server. We can also see further details of a specific database. Now your server should be listed in the connections, along with its databases and their tables. It will be also available in the new connection pane, from where you can quickly connect to it at any time without entering connection details again. Here you can create new query or a notebook. Let's create a new notebook. You can select which language to use from here. Let's use SQL. Click on the Add code to start writing code. Let's select our target database using the Use command. Now, we can use the Select command to display some data from a table. Click on the Run button to see the results. Let's close this notebook and create another using Python code. Click on the New Notebook and select Python as kernel from this drop-down. First time, you are required to either install Python or select the one already installed. Let's go on with new Python installation. Click on the Install button. Azure Data Studio will first download all the required files, and then it will install Python on your system. This may take some time. Once the installation is complete, you can add and run Python code inside Azure Data Studio. Let's declare two variables, x and y, and assign them some numbers. Now, let's multiply these variables and display the result. Run the code to see the result. And here is the result. Let's also print a message containing some text. Again, run the code to view the results. This is a very useful feature, bringing the power of Python to Azure Data Studio. Let's close the notebook now. We can clear the output window using the Clear Output button. Let's create a new query. To select your target database, use the Use command. Now, use the Select command to display some data. Date is also a reserved word, therefore we must use brackets to refer to the date column. We can multiply the price and units fields to create sales values. Enter the name of the table from where these values are going to be selected. Run the code to display the results. Sales column has no name. We can add a name in the select command. Now we have proper name for our sales column. You can view further details in the messages here. We can save our query results as CSV from here. After a file is saved as CSV, it is automatically opened for viewing. We can also save query results as Excel file and open the same after it is saved. This is a very useful feature. We can also save query results as JSON, Markdown, and XML formats. Finally, we can display the results as a chart. A chart is very useful to quickly visualize and understand the data. There are multiple types of chart, which you can select from the chart type drop-down. And you can even select table as chart type, which will display data in tabular form. You can also change the location of legend using the legend position drop-down. Now, if we go to the databases and select this database we are working on, we will see this page. This is actually a dashboard where we can display charts as well. So, let's display the chart that we have just created right here on this dashboard. First, we will save this query with an appropriate name. Then we will click here and create an insight. We will make sure that the SQL query has correct address in the insight. Then, we will copy the entire insight and we will go to settings. Here we will search for dashboard and look for database widget dashboard. We need to edit the JSON file behind this dashboard. And here, we will paste the insight we copied earlier. We can make any changes we need to this code, including the change of chart name, which is currently my widget. Let's call this widget Sales by Date. Now, save these settings and go back to the dashboard. Remember, this dashboard can be accessed from databases and then selecting the relevant database. And here is the chart that we just created. Back to settings, we can quickly change this chart into a line chart by simply changing bar into line. And now, when we open the dashboard, it is a line chart. Since this is a dashboard, we can add more charts here as well. To add another chart to our dashboard, let's create another SQL query. We will use the use command to select the database. Then we will use the select command to get data from our desired table. This time we will get sales data by product ID. The product ID should not be repeating in the table. We can group the data by product ID. To do that, first we will aggregate the sales using sum function. Then we will group the data by product ID. Let's run the code again. So, these are our sales by product ID. Let's change the chart to a donut chart. Let's move the legend to the right side. We need to save this query before proceeding further. Now, let's create an insight based on this visual and change its name to sales by product. Then copy this insight and go to our dashboard. Here, just like previous insight, we will paste this insight too. We can close all unnecessary files now. Let's go to the databases and open the dashboard we just created. And here is our dashboard with both charts we created through insights. Now, you may have noticed a small pop-up every time we started creating a chart, recommending some extension. So let's give it a try as well. To display this recommendation, let's create a chart again. And here is the recommendation message. Let's click on the Show Recommendation button. The extension recommended by Azure Data Studio is called Sanddance. Let's install this extension and see what happens. The extension has been installed. There are some previews of the extension which you can view. It seems like a good visualization tool, which has 3D charts too. Let's go back to our query and see what has changed. And after installation of Sanddance, when you open the result tab, you will notice that there is now another button named visualization below the chart button. And when we click on this button, the Sanddance visualization will show up. It's a chart with many settings. Let's change total by from count to sum. Size should be by sales, not product ID. You can also change chart types, which are limited but useful. From chart colors, you can change various color options and select color schemes as well. In data browser, you can filter and select chart data. When selecting, chart data appears on the left side in the data browser pane. You can change column types when filtered is selected in scope. In Select by Search pane, you can select data using search criteria. For example, let's search for data points higher than 50,000 and select them. As you can tell from the chart, none of the columns are higher than 50,000, therefore all of them will be unselected. Let's select columns having value higher than 2500. Great, we can add many expressions like this here. The next pane is of snapshot, using which we can take snapshot of the chart. We can also check the history of changes we made to the chart. The last event in your history is animated in the transitions pane. We will first size by product ID, and then by sales, and then see it in the animation. So, the last event was change of size by to sales, which is being animated here. In the settings pane, you can change various settings such as changing text size, show or hide axis, show or hide legends. and see system information. And with this, we end our tutorial today. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.